Basically, BSCPL is an infrastructure company. We build roads, bridges, and we are part of building up the nations. Not only in India, we have built abroad also. So in that course of this thing, as one of the wings, we took up the real estate, which is in the year 2006. And then, you know, we did a first project in Hyderabad, and later on we moved our focus onto the Chennai also, where in Chennai we have done a very large project of 100 acres. And then we have started in Bangalore also. About 5 years back we started in Bangalore, and we are doing a couple of projects in Bangalore. These three are the cities where we are developing, where we are into the in the real estate sector. So if you see in Chennai project, we do have product, we do have a product. One project which has got a product of somewhere around 1.5 crores to 3 crores. That's a very small project of about 4.5 acres. Other than that, most of us, we are focused on the middle income segment, where it falls between 45 to 75 lakhs. That is the segment which we are catering to. The potential buyers, most of the people are, you know, I mean, all segments are there. Be it IT, be it, you know, even a government employee, a central government employee with a recent pay commission. They are doing good. So that also is there. They are also our customers. Businessmen is our customers. Mostly, I would like to put it this way. The customers whom we are looking at is end users. We are not in the game of giving it to the investors per se. So we are mainly focusing on the end user market. If you look at all our projects, which is completed as of today, 90% of the people are the end users who are staying there. So that is the strength which we get. Because of that, what happens is that for me, from marketing to sell the product, referral sales helps me quite a lot. It fits into a middle and an upper middle segment. And wherein, you know, again, see, that product is also is between 50 lakhs to 90 lakhs maximum. All about 90% of the flats falls within the 75 lakhs to 80 lakhs segment only. So the few flats will go beyond 80 lakhs. So that's the segment which we are in there. We are on time, and we hope to deliver it on time. So that's the progress. The progress wise, we are comfortable. There are some delays, yes, but those delays is because of little on the force majeure class, which is there, you know. So based on that, there are some strikes somewhere, you know, some material is not available, like that. There are some about 1 or 2 months of delay, which hopefully we are catching up the time. One is the quality of work, starting from the design perspective to the execution perspective. You know, we look at the minute points which is required for the any house. What happens is that whenever we are looking at a design of a product, we look at as if we are using that product. So that is how we can ensure a better circulation space for the people and better utility of this space. And at the same time, the efficiency of the space is also very important. And that is how, you know, what we promise to the customer, and that is how the customer is getting into our product. See, in terms of the delay, per se, you know, what happens is that, for example, I'll tell you in Chennai today, what we are doing. We are having a project where I'm supposed to deliver it by December 2017, okay? But if you really look at it, from 6 months, I have a problem with the sand. Sand strike is going on. There is a mines and geologists issues are there. So these issues, when it comes to it, you know, we intimate the customer in advance that this is going to happen. I mean, we'll take a little more time. For example, the Vardha, which happened in 2016 in Chennai, that kills time. Normally what happens, the moment these issues happens, you know, there will be, the laborers will move out. So again, to put them back into the system, it takes equal amount of time which is lost. Suppose if I lose 2 months because of the whatever the calamity which is happening, next 2 months is required for me to bring back the laborers to the original strength. So for that, we inform the people in advance. We will tell through mailers or through, you know, having an interaction one-on-one. And in fact, we have called everybody and we have spoken to them that this is the thing. And we have taken some 3 months time extra for to deliver in Chennai. So that is how, that is the practice which we are doing. In any house, there will be typically about 3 generations will be there. All the 3 generations need to use. For him, he does not want to, after the, for example, if you take my Silas project, the moment he comes back from the office, after his full day of work and things like that, he need not go out for in search of any of the entertainment or in search of any of your exercise or in a relaxation per se. So that is why we have called it as Silas. Silas is nothing but in woods. That is the meaning of it. So that means the greenery which we are providing, the facilities which we are giving over there, is, that itself is sufficient for him to move around. You have old folks corner over there. You have children play area there. And whatever which is required for the youth to use that. Maybe gymnasium or the badminton court, facility, anything, you know. So that's how we plan, and that is how, you know, they need not, I mean, that's the lifestyle which they get into in our projects. If you really see, I'll give it an example. Say, for example, what we have done in Chennai. When we handed over the first villa to a customer, we ensured that it's a horizontal development. For your information, it's a 57 acres of development with all roads and independent villas, ground plus three apartments, and then the row houses. When we handed over the first set of things, whatever the things which is essential for that customer to be there, that was in place. For example, wide roads, that's all concrete roads. STP, which is required, sewer treatment plant, water treatment plant, and the park, which is required. So those things we will concentrate on first and we will give it to them. That means, you know, if you look at Silas, when we are handing over the first phase itself, we will complete the club for them. We will complete the all other, the common facilities which are required. Like, as I said, you know, old folks corner or the children play area, amphitheater, all these things we will put in place. So infrastructure will be in place for him once he comes in. He will not feel that, you know, I'm let down. We have projects in Chennai, Hyderabad and Bangalore. In Hyderabad, we are coming up with two projects. One is about 2.2 million square foot of residential development. Another one is about 1.2 million square foot of commercial development. Both are in very good location. We are almost, you know, through with all the approvals. Just the final approval we are awaiting for that. And we are going to start that. That is as far as Hyderabad is concerned. In Chennai, we have got another project. Other than whatever which is running now, two projects which we are running now. Other than that, we have a large project of about 3.3 million square foot, which is a multi-storied development. That also is in the final stage of sanction. Other than that, we have about 2-3 projects at Chennai. And in Bangalore, we have Silas, which is up and running. We have one project in Kogilur, that is in the on the Bangalore Belt Road area. And we have another project in northeast of this thing, where we call it as Hennur. So there is another about 24 acres of development which will be coming up. So, and we are looking at one commercial development also in Bangalore. So this is the, we want to concentrate only in the southern part, maybe, you know, up to Pune or Bombay. That is the idea what we have. We want to develop, we want to concentrate on this part of the country. The selection of a property is very important. Whenever we select a property, what we will do is that we do a survey for that. Once we do a survey, we ensure what is the future development that is happening in that area, what is the present connectivity which is there. So looking at that, we'll understand what exactly is going to happen around. So that is how we select. If that is not there, we don't take the project there. See, we are, as I told you in the beginning, no, we are not catering it to the investor sector. We are catering it to the end user. So when I'm doing it for an end user, we always keep in our mind that the social connectivity or the, you know, infrastructure facility, which is very important for the customer. So that is how we look at it. The selection of a project is a success of a project. 80% we have done with the project if we select a good location. See, what happens if you do a larger project, as I have done in Chennai? There we have put two schools. One is the regular CBSE school, another is an international school also. For a projects like 10 acres, we cannot do that. That is why I said earlier that while selecting the property itself, we look at all these things which is there in the environment, whether there is, it is available, what is the distance. If you see, all our brochures will contain that this
school is so far, like that, you know, we mentioned the distances. So this is what we will do for the smaller projects. But for a project of this size, what I just now told you about 3 million square foot, which we are coming up in Chennai, we are putting up a school within the campus. And also you will have supermarket, everything, which is in the larger size. Depending upon the size of the project, we put up the markets, I mean, supermarket size also in that, proportionate to that. So that is how we ensure that for their lifestyle, it doesn't, I mean, give any problem. As I said, you know, in Chennai, we do have Nilgiris with us. So it's a very large format, which is there with us. So that's how we have worked out. We do maintain the project for some time, and later on we will give it to the association. See, we, in Chennai, we have maintained for about 5 years, the project, and now we have given it to the customer, I mean, the residents association for about, for the first phase. So the similar, the second phase, you know, we would like to maintain for some time, and then, you know, hand it over to the association. See, what the basic principle which we have kept is that we want to keep the sales separate and the construction separate. So that is how the whole thing was moving as till date. Now what is happening is that the government policy, the new government policy, has not helped us in terms of the getting the finance from the banks or anything. However, having said that, we do have the other NBFCs who are there, who are very friendly, they know the business. So we are getting finance from them also. The banks still treat this as a not as such a priority sector for them. So maybe when the time, you know, moves, again we get the original glory, the banks also starts funding us. And of course, we have a very good relationship with the banks, and we do have certain, you know, finances availed from the banks to put up our construction. That is why if you really see whatever the Silas construction which we are doing, whether the what happens in the marketing angle or sorry sale angle, we don't look at it, we just go on constructing that. So by virtue of which, what happens is that we always get the customer to take the project because he sees the progress. In today's perspective, any customer, unless and until he sees the action at the site, he will not take the property. The days were gone where we used to sell on the drawing board. No more that. We have to put, we have to show him that, you know, we are doing something in the product. So that is how we have disconnected. And yes, as your question is pertaining to the governmental regulations, that is not so friendly as of now. We are hoping that it will become friendly shortly. RERA is something which is good from the customer angle. And what happens is that everybody will become more serious onto the payments from their side and the delivery from the our side. So since both the things have been tackled, it will give a better result. And at the same time, there is every chance these fly-by-night operators will be removed from the system. Then you know what happens, there will be a lot of stability to the market, and also the industry itself will be seen in a better perspective in terms of bank. Your previous question with respect to banks, definitely those things will get improved once this we start following up this RERA, whatever the regulations which are there, by virtue of which we all become streamlined. Once you are streamlined, the things will become much more easier for us. So this is, but there are some teething problems in that. There are some, you know, corrective things which need to be taken up, which as developers, we have to talk to the government. Maybe those things, if it is in place, the whole RERA comes up with a better perspective for us. If you look at GST, GST is something, it has, for a project which you are starting today, it's really a good one. For the project which is there up and running, there are some difficulties. If things are explained properly, and if things are sorted out properly, and if the understanding comes in totality, then I think, you know, it is a good this thing for us, because one tax all over India. So which gives you a better this thing, because otherwise, you know, you fill this excise duty, that duty, this duty. So all these problems have been culminated into one as GST, which is giving us a better thinking. But it will take some time to consolidate properly. If you really look at it, that scheme is for a particular size of loan. If you take a property of say 40 lakhs or 50 lakhs, 20% he pays, 80% is it goes to 30 and odd lakhs. So at that point of time, he may not be in a position to come into that particular bracket. So with that, the usage of that for a mid-segment is not much. For the affordable housing, yes, it is a boon. And definitely, that is going to create more houses for that segment. All the while, the South was taking lead in Bangalore. But once the focus shifted, once the airport came this side, the whole focus got shifted to the Bangalore North. Bangalore North, Northeast, and of course Southwest. These are all the 2 points where you know you can get a traction from now on. That is because the connectivity is better. If you see Northeast and the East, you have very good working population. So for them, the housing, if you put it in Northeast, you know, the movement, the way the people can commute would be better. For example, if you take Manyata Tech Park here, or the other commercial hubs which are coming in the north, and the ITPL, that Whitefield area. So those areas are getting well connected with this outer ring road. And also there are some possible infrastructure facilities have been created.